Welcome back, MechanicaLEi. Did you know that Convolution theorem helps to understand a system's behavior based on current and past events? This makes us wonder, what is Convolution theorem? Before we jump in, check out the previous part of the series to learn about what inverse Laplace transforms are. Now, partial fractions method, a prerequisite to studying the convolution theorem, is a technique for decomposing functions of the form y of s so that inverse Laplace transform can be determined in a straightforward manner. It is applicable to functions of the form y of s equals q of s upon p of s, where q of s and p of s are polynomials and the degree of q is less than the degree of p. For simplicity, we assume that q and p have real coefficients. After reducing the right-hand side to a sum of two or more Laplace transforms, we simply apply the inverse Laplace transforms on them to reduce them to small y of t forms. Coming back to the topic at hand, the convolution theorem states that if the Laplace transform of f of t and g of t are capital F of s and g of s respectively, then Laplace inverse of capital F of s into capital G of s is equal to f into g of t. Suppose you want to find the inverse transform x of t from capital X of s. If you can write capital X of s as a product of capital F of s into capital G of s, where f of t and g of t are known, then the above result x of t equals f into g of t. Hence, we first saw what partial fractions method is, and then went on to see what convolution theorem is.
So like, subscribe and comment with your feedback to help us make better videos. Thanks for watching.
Also, thanks a lot for those constructive comments. You help the channel grow. So, here are the top MechanicaLEIs of our last videos.
In the next episode of MechanicaLEI, find out what applications of boundary value problems are.